Hello everyone, this is Elohim and welcome back to Blood and Magic. This is episode 7. And I want to let you know, I have been very busy in between episodes. So let's jump on this and let me show you what I've been doing. Alright, the first thing you're going to notice was I am wearing a new chest plate there. That is the Sanguine chest plate, I believe it was called. Sanguine Robes. It is a combination of one of the armors from Thaumcraft mixed with blood magic, just like the Sanguine helmet. And it's nighttime, so let's go ahead and hop in the bed real quick. Alright, and we do have this furnace upgraded to the Hell Furnace, the next to highest tier for it. And it also can hold 2 stacks of items to be smelted, 2 stacks of fuel, 2 stacks of items that have been smelted. It also has the advanced ore processing upgrade. It means every ore I smelt in here, I get 2 instead of 1. And this is a advanced fuel efficiency upgrade. This means it just is better about fuel, the way you make these. The advanced ore processing upgrade uses 4 diamonds, 2 obsidian, 2 piston, and the normal ore processing upgrade. The reason you want the advanced is the advanced will not break, where the normal one will. The way you make the normal one is flint, a piston, and some stone. As for the fuel one, 4 diamonds, 3 eyes of ender, a gas tier, and a fuel efficiency upgrade. It took me almost all week to get this gas tier. And the fuel efficiency upgrade is 4 ender pearls to 4 blocks of lapis and coal. Not too bad. As you see, you will notice a hand mirror in my inventory. It is a magic hand mirror. I'll show you where that leads to later. I have upgraded all the chests to crystal and added stands for potions, since I keep getting so many of them. No, I did not make any of these. These are all from loot bags and chests and everything. Come out here. Remember all those jars I had before? Well, I've upgraded since then. The jars I had were normal jars. These are called void jars. Normal jars, when they're full, no more essence can be put in them. Void jars, even if this is full, more essence can be put in it. You lose it, but it keeps you from having all those jars sitting around causing lag. Got more golems working. Is there only 2 over here now? I had 3. Ended up having to make 3 of them because the one I originally had over here disappeared. I hate when the game glitches. Some changes to the Infernal Furnace. There is now a mirror sitting up here over a hungry chest to feed items in. And items that get spit out go into another magic mirror. Over here with the Blood Altar, we have upgraded this to a Tier 4. Now, the only blocks that are important in the Tier 4 are, of course, the runes. You just add 1 more to each end. You take it out 1, 2, and drop down 1. And the only other block that matters is these blocks right up here, the top ones. I just decided to use the large bloodstone bricks for all this because, well, for 1 weak blood shard and 1 piece of stone, you get 32 of these. And I think it looks good. Currently, this altar is empty because of upgrading the capacity of it again. It has caused it to empty out. This altar can currently hold quite a bit. But that's one of the problems with the blood altar, is it actually has 2 internal tanks. One that is used for up here, and one that is used for if you have something where you, a mod where you can pipe liquids. And you end up having to fill that secondary tank up first. Yeah, this can now hold 122,000 life points. But, so that means both tanks hold that amount. So I have to fill that second tank up before I can get the top part filled up. I'll be taking care of that, though. And I know I haven't showed y'all much with the branch mine down here. There has been a major change. You know, it was before just different branches on a mine. Well, we have changed it. We've upgraded it via Thaumcraft. Let me show you what we got here. Yeah, these steps go down a long way. Actually, I'll probably replace these blocks with actual steps to make it faster. Okay. Looks normal, right? Yeah. We have cleared all this out, and I didn't do it by hand. We did it with this thing. It is the Arcane Boar. Now, the top part and the bottom part are two different builds. I'll show you the recipes for them. We also have a magic mirror back here for the items to go into. This lever, the boar requires a redstone signal, so it's just easy to throw a lever next to it, cut it on, blah, blah, blah. It also requires a wand focus of excavation, which is the green thing on the end, other end out there. And it requires a pickaxe. Now, whatever pickaxe you put in here, it will use the durability of that pickaxe. So I like placing the bound pickaxe, which has no durability. So I never have to worry about replacing it. If your pickaxe has an enchantment like Fortune or Silk Touch, it does affect it. If I put Silk Touch on this, everything it mined would be Silk Touched. I'd rather have Fortune, though. Get more stuff. Real quick, let me show you the recipe for these wonderful little things. And yes, I have been doing more research for the Arcane Boar. This is the setup for the ritual. You need Air Shard, Earth Shard, two Great Wood Planks, two gold ingots, a diamond pickaxe, and a diamond shovel, and this many points of each of these essences. For the bottom, you need four Great Wood Planks, four iron ingots, and a dispenser done in the Arcane Workbench. Uses this much. And as for the mirrors, it is this setup for a ritual, this much essence. Now, to make the mirrored glass, quicksilver and a glass pane, the hand mirror, a stick, a mirror, an empty map, and a compass, and these essences. And what the hand mirror does is these mirrors can only be linked to one other mirror. So this is linked to one mirror. The ones up at the furnaces are each linked to one mirror. This is a shortcut into it. In fact, this hand mirror is linked to the other mirror that this one's attached to. So items that go into this mirror right here on the ground and items that I pass into this hand mirror both come out of the same mirror. Makes it easy for not having to make an extra mirror. And I'll go ahead and show you where these go to. I've been using the advanced ender portals. This one will take me home. And this one will take me to my storage area, which is where the mirrors are set up. Still am working on it. But as you see, there's the mirror for the mining laser. There's the mirror that stuff coming from the infernal furnace comes out of. This mirror send stuff to the Infernal Furnace. I've got him set up to send iron right now. He'll eventually be set up to send anything that can be smelted. Now, yes, this is a lot of chest. And I've got some auto crafters over here. Because, as you see, he's picking up the iron ingots and bringing them over here. Eventually, I'll have another golem that'll take the stuff out of those and put them into the chest. But I don't want to take and use space badly. So anything that can be turned into a block, I have an auto crafter set to make it into blocks. Oh. Let's clear up freehand real quick. Redstone. This one up here. Iron nuggets to iron ingots, which then go down through the hopper to become iron blocks. Same thing here with gold. Lapis, diamonds, and emeralds. All for storage efficiency. Now, this storage area is not near my home. This is actually out in an area I was exploring. And there is a slime chunk somewhere close to here. I haven't found exactly which place, where it is exactly, but I will. This is where I've been getting all my slime balls, is up on the surface. In fact, if you watch one of the earlier videos when you see me kill slimes, that is directly above the storage room. Excuse me for that cough. Now, in the mining world, I really haven't spent much time in here. I do have this set up. Got some potion shelves for the potions that came in through here. As you see, we do have a little bit of stuff. Two ender pearls. And if I wanted to, I could craft two ender pearls out of these. I'll eventually get around to doing that. It's really all that I've been doing in there so far. Let's get that sun to go back down. Alright, now, this way, you'll notice the animals are gone. You'll notice the structure over there, some of the farms have changed. The animals are actually down here, because where this torch is, eventually is going to be a pipe like those over there, going down to a lamp for that'll cause them to breed faster. And I'll also have a golem down there killing them and a golem gathering the drops. I had to rearrange the farms. I had to move the carrot farm over here because, see these lamps? These lamps make them grow faster when I have the right essence. Oh, I'm actually only down, got one coal left, but the item that I smelt in here is seeds. And we're out. But that's okay. We'll get more. But the reason I had to move the carrot farm is because when the carrot farm was up here and they were harvesting, carrots and potatoes were getting mixed in with the other farms. At one point, this farm had only two things of wheat left, and the rest of it was carrots and potatoes. I did that through two blocks of cobblestone, but it did. Wolves are still over here. I actually got some more wolves from a lucky block. I will be adding them to it. Now this machine over here, or device, for those of y'all that don't know what this is an iron farm. 1.710, this version still works in. Once you go up to 1.8, it doesn't work anymore. But this is a lot easier to build than the Iron Titan. That if you watch Hermitcraft, you've seen Tango Tech built, most likely. But yeah, I've got these villagers up here. They've been breeding away. Total of 40 doors. I could actually stack this all the way up to the build limit of the world if I wanted, but I don't want to think about the lag that it's going to cause if I did it. Excuse me again. Okay. That's really all I've got done in between episodes. I do have some beans growing over here. which once this one matures fully, I'll come over, harvest them all, replant. They're just good for getting essences over here out of. What I want to do today is I want to make a nice handy little item to have that is made through golemancy. See, we already have the hungry chest. I want to get a traveling trunk. Now, this is all in preparation for going after the wither. The traveling trunk is literally a chest that follows you around. It's extra inventory. So, to make this trunk, we're going to have to do a ritual. To do the ritual, I need an iron ingot, 2 great wood planks, a wood golem, and a hungry chest. I have pretty much all that stuff, not a problem. I have to make a golem to do it though. And there's a couple of ways to do it. Yes, this machine is a new add-on too. Let's see, do I have any great wood in here? Logs is what I need. I'm going to show you the first way you have to make golems on here. Then I'll show you the new and improved advanced way. Because I told y'all I would show y'all how to do this with making the golems, and it's time. As you see, most of the stuff in here has been transferred over. A lot of the chests have a lot less items. Now, let's see. Check on how much essences I need to make this. Give me my thumb come back. 4. So that's not enough, but I do have another source of zombie of the rotten flesh. Alright. Should have some iron in here. No, I don't. Looks like it's gonna be going to the storage area to get it. Gotta go there anyway to get the soul sand, because that's all in the chest I have there. Didn't hold down the right click long enough. There we go. As you notice, with these, it does no damage to me. Okay. Well, my soul sand's not here. Figure out where I put my soul sand at. Oh, while I'm here, let me show you how this works. The hand mirror. It comes out the mirror over there. I don't think I've added the half slab to this guy's list. No. So these are all the items I have been picking up. So we'll add this half slab to it because this is my nether guy. There we go. Open the inventory back up and it'll throw it out. There we go. Now, the way I'm going to show you how to make the golem that I need is very wasteful, actually. Now, here's a soul sand. I need 4 pieces. This is actually a very wasteful way of making the golems, but it's the way you have to start out. And I need some trapdoors. I got 1, but I need 4. I don't think I have any wood left over here. We'll check. Not bad, I do have wood up there. at the Thawmcraft place. You can use the great wood and the silverwood planks to make the trap doors. All works just the same. And might as well go ahead and grab the two of these I need. I'll just use this auto crafter on the floor. Alright. It's not gonna let me use that wood. This is odd because I've used silver wood to do it, but oh well. Zombies, no account. Just hop over here and cut down a tree real quick. Could use the apples anyway. Now the auto crafter is up in here so that if I ever need to mass produce items that don't have to be made over there. By the way, the cores for the golems, this is how you make them. It's a miter with four bricks. That might have been because I didn't put them in there in the pattern. I forgot. Auto crafter has to have the pattern put in. Okay. And craft them all up. It's always easier to get rid of the recipe up here before you grab the stuff out. Oh, well, I've got a button. That happens with wood, but that's okay. Alright. We have everything we need to make the golem. Let's go sleep real quick. Get this sun to come full circle. And before I do that, I'm actually going to go ahead and grab the iron I need. Yeah, with the few amount of villagers that are up in here, this hasn't been producing a lot. Just over a stack so far that I've taken out of it. But the villagers will keep breeding, and we'll get more. Plus, as I find villagers, I'll be bringing them back and adding them to it. And once we beat the Wither, I'll have a way to resurrect villagers that have died. Cost of experience. Now, to make a golem, in the first way you have to do it, need four trap doors in there, four soul sand, four rotten flesh, and the item the golem is made out of, and there we go, we got a golem. Now, this is all well and good, it's time consuming, and then there's always the problem of that. Let me show you the better way of making them now. If I can get through the door. This machine right here, the alchemical construct. And it's right here. Takes two alchemical construct things and a crucible. Does have to have a heat source, does not need water. Put them together, right click it with a wand. Now, right now the way I have it set up, it can only hold one recipe at a time. If I add these to it, it adds more. I'm not really worried about it though. What you do, take the jars of the essences out there. Like for a golem, you would want the jar of essence that has humanness, which is human, motus, which is movement, and spiritus, which of course is spirit. You hook them up to these pipes down here, and then you right click there, and you would put the item needed in here. Like in the case of the wood golem, the great wood log, you would put here and flip through the recipes it can do. Tells you all the ingredients, the amount. You click it on the one you want it to make. It makes it and spits it out into here. As you see, I have several stone golems that I've made this way. Making golems this way, much more efficient. But let's get this ritual started. Need one more thing. Hungry chest. I'm just going to grab one of the ones I have in here. As you can see, these are some of the research I've done. These are the ones that will give me warp. There's some that I need to do. All the ones that wouldn't give me warp have already been added into the Thaumacon. We'll take this one. It only has two items in it, so what do you get? I could always craft another one. And yes, as you see, there are hungry chests over here. These are the essence crystallizers. Each one has one. So that it keeps making the crystals. Alright, let's throw the hungry chest here. Now let's look at the pattern. Because these rituals are very much about pattern. You have to put the patterns right or things can go horribly wrong. As you see, this one, instability, minor. There are some rituals that have a much higher instability. Now, you want to keep everything symmetrical with this. Now, it doesn't matter if this iron ingot goes on anyone, as long as it has the planks on both sides and is directly across from the wood golem. So let's do this. I'm going to put iron there. Plank there. Plank there. And the wood golem. Not the way I wanted to put him down, so give me a second while I pick him back up. I don't want him standing on the pedestal. I need him to be in that form. So for the golem, shift right click him on it. Now let's get the essences we need. We need Etar, or however you say that, it's the travel one. We need Motus for movement. We're out of Motus. Easy enough to fix. Let's see. That's in there. Start producing Motus essence. We'll go ahead and finish grabbing. We need Spiritus. I believe the last one was Voidus or Vacuus, the void. I do have these in alphabetical order. These jars, you want to put them kind of close to where the ritual is set up at. How much Motus did we need? Let's find out. Yeah, like I said, golems use motus when you make them, so that's actually where all my motus has been going there or being crystallized. We only need 4 points, so that's 15. We're good. They'll put the rest of it up there. Now, I can put these in whatever order I want, space them around, blah, blah, blah. It doesn't matter. Get your wand out. And by the way, these crystals and heads, I think I told you in previous episode, they do lower the chance of instability. Right-click that. It just sucks the essences it needs right out of the jars. If you have the jars too far away, there will be lightning. The iron's going into it. This plank's going into it. The golem's going into it. That plank's going into it. And it is now done. Right-click the pedestal. We now have the traveling trunk. Place them out. Look at this little guy. Holds this much amount of a normal trunk. Has your name. He does have a health. If I click that, he'll stay there. Unclick it, he'll follow me. If I get tired of him following me, left click him with the Golem Mancer bell, and he gets picked up. Now there is a downside to this. Let me show you. Let's throw these saplings in there. I pick him up, he drops everything he was holding. Now there is a way around this. And we're going to actually do that now. Because I want him to be where I can pick him up and carry him with the items still in him. And he is able to be upgraded to do that. There's actually several different upgrades you can do for him. I need 8 gold nuggets. That's only 7. Now, the upgrades for him are the same upgrades that you can do to the golems. They are all based on the 6 basic essences. In fact, you use 8 gold nuggets and a shard of the type that you want the upgrade to be. In this case, I do believe I want it to be the order one. Let me double check that. See, the air upgrade makes it where he moves faster. Earth, let's see, he can carry more. Fire makes it where he will defend me if I'm attacked. With the water one, with this upgrade installed, the traveling trunk cannot be opened or picked up by anyone else but the master. I'm not really worried about that. I'm in a private world. Yep. This is the one I want. Golem upgrade order. With this upgrade installed, the traveling trunk will retain its items when it is picked up using a Golem Mancer bell. It will drop items as normal when shift clicked is used. But as long as I just normal left click it, I can pick him up with items in it. Let's clear this out because I need to use it for this. Gold nuggets around like that. Whatever shards you want in the middle. There we go. And we'll throw these back up here. I'll organize them out later. Not really worried about it right now. Now it has an upgrade right there. Now, that is happening again. Saplings are still in him. I don't want him carrying those saplings around though. But also right now I don't want him getting hurt, so he will be going in my inventory now. Mobs are definitely getting a little more hostile towards me, it feels like. Alright. Get that sun back up. A few things I need to drop off real quick. About the lag there. Golemancer Bell in there. Now, today we are going to make something that is super powerful. Just need a few items. By now, y'all should recognize what I'm making on this one. I need 4 strings. Oh, and I'm out of one of the items I need, so let's go grab some. Sure, we can find some out here easy enough. There it is. Clay. And Vayne might grab it all up. And yes, it did stay in block form. I have silk touch on my shovel. Not that it really matters. I am creating a new mask. The only item I would need string and clay for. Now the other items we are going to need, we're going to need 4 diamonds. And 8 gas tiers. This mask is expensive. Let's make the mold first. For those of y'all that have been following this series, you should remember that recipe. Now for this one, just need the 4 diamonds there. I need half the gas tiers there and half here. To make moon tiers, I need 4 of these. Mask mold there. Moon tier on each side, and we now have Majora's Mask. Now, like all the masks, I can wear it. Doesn't look very cool, in my opinion. I think it would look better if it's bigger or full head. And there is no effect. So why is this mask so expensive? Walk outside and I'll show you. Right click, you see a dark energy radiates from the mask. You notice it now has the durability bar. Right click it again, that goes away. Dark energy dissipates. But with the dark energy there, creative mode flight. This will be very handy. and there's an unlimited amount of uses for it. So it's really OP. Now, another item I want to make today is this right here. It is called an empty socket. I just want to show you how it's made. Now you grab four of these weak blood charts. Yes, as you can see, I've been working. That actually goes there because there's an orb in between those. I'm very busy. Now, as you see, a diamond in the middle, four glass, and these makes an empty socket. Now, what I do with this socket, I need my blood altar full, so I'm going to be filling it up in between episodes. But you just put this into the blood altar, and let me show you. Tier 3 blood altar and 30,000 points of blood to fill it up. Now, okay, pretty cool. There are two uses really for this filled socket. And this is the only use for the empty socket. Filled socket. Four filled sockets, two stone, and the tier three or higher blood orb creates a soul armor forge. The soul armor forge is very important because the most powerful OP armor I've ever used is made from these filled sockets and the soul armor forge. You don't craft them though in a crafting table. What you literally do is, I'm going to grab some other blocks to demonstrate with. Grab this TNT. Pretend that this TNT is the filled sockets, and we'll say the empty socket is the soul armor forge. To make the boots for the really OP armor, filled sockets like that, armor forge in between them. Right click it, those become the boots. The soul armor forge stays there. But filling these sockets up is very tedious, which is why I will be doing it off camera. Also, as OP as the armor is, I do not have a soul network stable enough yet to support it. So part of getting ready to fight the Wither is getting that ready. It's also why I haven't been using the bound tools and weapon very often. But we're going to fix that. With a ritual. Now, I don't have everything I need yet to do it. It's another thing I'm going to be handling in between episodes. I want to show you. I'm going to be putting a ritual right here above this blood altar, which will provide a more steady flow of life points into it and into my soul network. Now that we have this Majora's Mask, though, which it does not have to be in your hotbar, we can travel around a little easier. And looking at the time, that looks to be all the time I have for recording today. If you like what you saw, please hit that like button. Please feel free to comment. If this is the first video you've seen by me, please hit that subscribe button if you'd like to see more from me. Also, my channel is relatively new. If you like what you saw here, please feel free to share my videos with your friends. You know, help me make this channel grow. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Also, you'll be able to find the links to my Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook page in the description below.